email has become indispensable in the modern office. But its widespread use has also brought the frustration of phishing, spam, and spoofing. In this video, we will show you how to ensure your organization's mail security through three ways: authentication, anti-spam, and antivirus. You'll find the timestamp of each section in the video description. Before you start, make sure you've already set up Synology MailPlus server. You can check out the previous video to learn about installing and initializing MailPlus. Email passes through multiple email servers to its destination. During this process, hackers can target mail servers and modify messages to trick users into thinking the email was sent from a trusted mail server. For this reason, most mail servers will authenticate emails using SPF, DKIM, and DMARC and reject unauthenticated mail. Synology MailPlus uses these three types of authentication as well as DANE authentication to verify the identity of the recipient server. One or more of these authentication methods can be enabled by going to Security, Authentication. The above authentication methods are executed based on the information provided by a DNS server. Let's take a look at how these four authentication methods work, as well as how to set up DNS records. We'll use example.com as the domain name in the following demo. SPF is used to confirm that an email was sent by the mail server authorized to send emails on behalf of that domain. This prevents phishing or spam emails with bogus identities from being received. When you send an email from XYZ at example.com, the recipient's email server checks to see if the sender's IP address belongs to the sender's domain. If so, the email will be delivered to the recipient's inbox. If not, the email will be rejected. To provide your SPF information to other mail servers for verification, go to your public DNS server and create a new TXT record. Copy the text and modify it with your own IP information. This message tells the recipient server that emails from the above IP address is indeed sent from your domain. If the recipient server receives an email from your domain, but not from the above IP address, it will reject it. DKIM uses public and private keys to ensure that the content of the email has not been tampered with. When the email is sent, an exclusive private key is added to the header of the email. To ensure that the recipient can receive your email, the recipient's server will need to obtain the public key to decrypt the email. First, enable DKIM signing on your email by doing the following. Open MailPlus server and go to Domain. In this example, we will select example.com, Edit, Advanced. Enable the option for DKIM signing on outbound emails. Enter a prefix, then click Generate Public Key. The DKIM public key then needs to be published on your DNS server. Go to your public DNS server and use it to create a new TXT record. Copy the text and modify it with your own domain information and DKIM key. When a server receives an email from your domain, it will decrypt it using the public key, ensuring that the email was not modified after it was sent. DMARC is a verification method based on SPF and DKIM. By comparing the sender information from the header with content from the email, it will ensure that the email which has passed both SPF and DKIM has not been spoofed. SPF and DKIM must be configured first before enabling DMARC. To provide your DMARC information to a recipient server for verification, you can create a TXT record on your public DNS. Copy the text and modify it with your own domain information. This message will tell the recipient server that if the letter does not pass DMARC, put the email into quarantine and send a DMARC report to postmaster at example.com. DANE helps verify the identity of recipient servers to ensure that the recipient is not a fraudulent one. Before an email is sent, DANE will validate the recipient's identity by checking the recipient server's TLS certificate using TLSA information from DNS servers. By using the DNS SEC infrastructure, we can prevent security breaches by hackers through DNS pollution. Follow these steps to generate a TLSA record through MailPlus server. Click on Security, Authentication, Generate TLSA record. Deploy the TLSA record in your public DNS server. Enable DNS SEC on your DNS server. To understand more about configured DNS records, refer to the link in the description for more details. MailPlus is compatible with built-in anti-spam engines and DNSBL, as well as other gray listing functions to protect users from spam. You can enable anti-spam to automatically filter out unwanted emails. Go to Security, Anti-Spam. Enable the option for anti-spam engine. Choose an anti-spam engine. Outside of the thousands of anti-spam filtering rules set by Spam Engine, you can create your own spam filtering rules by clicking on Custom Spam Filter. If you want to further customize your anti-spam settings, click on Advanced. Here, you can upload customized spam assassin rules or configure keyword filters. Enabling the auto-learning function will train the accuracy of spam detection. When an email's spam score is higher than the preset score, the email will be analyzed. You can enable DNSBL to block suspicious IP addresses from connecting to MailPlus server. Under DNSBL, enable the option for post-screen protection against spam. Click the DNSBL settings button to edit the servers that should be checked. Click the Create button to add servers to be checked. Clicking on Settings will allow you to edit the DNSBL score threshold. When an email client's total score exceeds the specified value, requests for services from the client will be rejected. Graylisting improves spam filtering by temporarily rejecting suspicious emails. Typically, regular senders will try again after a while, but spammers will give up. Enable the option for graylist. Click Graylist Settings to manage lists of IP addresses or domains temporarily rejected. Clicking on Settings will allow you to specify the time period. MailPlus Integrated Antivirus Engine will scan all attachments from inbound and outbound emails. To enable the antivirus engine, open MailPlus server. Go to Security, Antivirus. Enable the antivirus engine and choose an engine to use. If you've purchased other antivirus engines, this will be available as an option. If you're using ClamAV as your antivirus engine, you can also enable additional options, such as use Google Safe Browsing Database to detect malicious links in emails, and use third-party databases to download their virus definitions. Click on Update Settings to set a schedule for updating your virus definition. You can also manually update your virus definition here. MailPlus offers three different actions for emails that are deemed infected or malicious. You can either delete the message, store it in quarantine, or send it to the recipient's mailbox as usual. Potentially infected emails can be viewed in the quarantine list. In addition, if there are emails you know for sure that you need to accept or block, you can go to Mail Delivery, Security, and configure the block list and allow list. After configuring these functions, you can now enjoy a secure MailPlus service. If you have any questions about MailPlus, please feel free to contact technical support for further assistance. For more on MailPlus, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on a video to keep watching.